Hello friends, welcome you all to my YouTube channel, myself Piyush Kumar Verma, and today in this video I am going to discuss about environmental impact assessment. So first of all, let me tell you about the environmental impact assessment and its definition. So EIA is a process of evaluating the likely environmental impacts of a proposed project or development, taking into account interrelated socio-economic, cultural, and human health impacts, both beneficial and adverse. But according to UNEP definition, UNEP defines environmental impact assessment as a tool used to identify the environmental, social, and economic impact of a project prior to decision making. It aims to predict environmental impacts at an early stage in project planning and design, find ways and means to reduce adverse impacts, shape projects to suit the local environment, and present the predictions and options to decision makers. Environmental impact assessment in India is statutorily backed by the Environment Protection Act 1986, which contains various provisions on EIA methodology and process. So now let us talk about the history of EIA in India. The Indian experience with environmental impact assessment began over 20 years back. It started in 1976-77, when the Planning Commission asked the Department of Science and Technology to examine the River Valley project from an environmental angle. Till 1994, environmental clearance from the central government was an administrative decision and lacked legislative support. So, on 27 January 1994, the then Union Ministry of Environment and Forests, under the Environment Protection Act 1986, promulgated an EIA notification making environmental clearance mandatory for expansion or modernization of any activity or for setting up new projects listed in Schedule 1 of the notification. Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change MoEFCC notified new EIA legislation in September 2006. The notification makes it mandatory for various projects such as mining, thermal plant, river valley infrastructure, road, highways, ports, harbors, and airports, and industries including very small electroplating or foundry units to get environmental clearance. However, unlikely the EIA notification of 1994, the new legislation has put the onus or responsibility of clearing projects on the state government depending on the size capacity of the project. So now let's talk about the EIA process. EIA involves the steps mentioned below. However, the EIA process is cyclical with interaction between the various steps. So first one is the screening, and screening involves the project plan is screened for scale of investment, location and type of development, and if the project needs statutory clearance. Scoping, that is the second step. The project's potential impact, zone of impact, mitigations, possibilities, and need for monitoring. Third step, collection of baseline data. Baseline data is the environmental status of study area. Step number four, impact prediction, positive and negative, reversible and irreversible, and temporary and permanent impacts need to be predicted, which presupposes a good understanding of the project by the assessment agency. Step number five, mitigation measures and EIA report. The EIA report should include the actions and steps for preventing, minimizing, or bypassing the impacts, or else the level of compensation for probable environmental damage or loss. Now, step number six, public hearing. On completion of EIA report, public and environmental groups living close to project site may be informed and consulted. Step number seven, decision making. Impact Assessment Authority, along with the experts, consult the project in charge along with consultant to take the final decision, keeping in mind EIA and EMP. EMP means Environmental Management Plan. Step number 8 involves monitoring and implementation of Environmental Management Plan. The various phases of implementation of the project are monitored. And finally, assessment of alternatives, delineation of mitigation measures, and environmental impact assessment report. It involves for every project possible alternatives should be identified and environmental attributes compared. Alternatives should cover both project location and project process technologies. Step number 10. Once alternatives have been reviewed, a mitigation plan should be drawn up for the selection option and supplemented with environmental management plan to guide the proponent towards environmental improvement. And last step, step number 11, risk assessment. So inventory analysis of hazard probability and index also form part of EIA procedure. So this slide involves generalized flow chart for EIA process. Now we shall talk about stakeholders in EIA process. So those who propose the project, the environmental consultant who prepare EIA on behalf of project proponent, the second, pollution control board, state or national, and the third, public, and fourth, the impact assessment agency, and fifth, regional centers of MOEFCC. So silent features of 2006 amendments to EIA notification. This is most important point. Environment Impact Assessment Notification 2006 has decentralized the environmental clearance projects by categorizing the developmental project into two categories. Category A, that will be appraised by national level, and category B, that will be appraised by state level appraisal committee. So category A projects are appraised at national level by impact assessment agency and the expert appraisal committee ESC, and category B projects are appraised at state level. State level Environment Impact Assessment Authority and state level expert appraisal committee are constituted to provide clearance to category B process projects. After 2006 amendment, the EIA cycle comprised of four stages: screening, scoping, public hearing, and appraisal. Some points should be kept in mind because examination point of view this can be asked. Category A projects require mandatory environmental clearance and thus they do not undergo the screening process. Category B projects undergo screening process and they are classified into two types. Category B1 projects mandatorily requires EIA. Category B2 projects do not require EIA. Thus, Category A projects and Category B projects undergo the complete EIA process, whereas Category B2 projects are excluded from complete EIA process. So now we are talking about what are the important points of EIA, or what is importance of EIA. EIA links environment with development for environmentally safe and sustainable development. EIA provides a cost-effective method to eliminate or minimize adverse impact of development projects. So EIA enables the decision makers to analyze the effect and developmental activities on the environment well before the development project is implemented. EIA encourages the adaptation of mitigation strategies in the developmental plan. And finally, the fifth point, EIA makes sure that the developmental plan is environmentally sound and within the limits of the capacity of assimilation and regeneration of the ecosystem.